Green Business Certified, proudly made in America, Anoush Botanicals and Organics, personal care for you, your home, pets, and babies too. We recently picked these beautiful Eureka lemons from our trees and our juicing oranges, and then our Meyer lemons. The Meyer lemons are a thinner skin, and you could almost just eat them if you were inclined to do so. We use these for our cooking, of course, and then we do use them in our personal care. Today we're going to start with these juicing oranges, and we're going to make marmalade. Hey, well, we soaked these all day. All morning, I should say. And then now we'll take a little brush to them. Because we're organic, many of these have dirt and who knows what on them. And it's just a good idea to use a brush to get some of the, you know, extra little things out of the crevices. And any skin or areas that are unappealing, like this one, we'll just use the juice. And we won't use the peel for the marmalade. So there's the uptake. So our oranges have been washed and scrubbed. And now we will proceed with the slicing and taking the seeds out, adding sugar. And I make our own apple base, which has the pectin from our apple trees. And this is also a base from limoncello that we like to add to our marmalade. So we will proceed. Okay, so our sugar is in, and wanted to point out we use a vegan organic sugar, just in case anyone was interested. So next we'll add our orange slices. The smell of orange is always fresh and beautiful, so we'll see. I have a feeling this may not be enough. Voila! There's nothing like a pot filled with oranges. So I will... Oh, I realized I need to add the lemons, a couple lemons that... mostly the juice. So I need to trim those up and get these them into the pot as well. In the meantime, I'll certainly put these on the stove. In this case, I will use two of the Meyer lemons, the thinner skinned, and one big Eureka, and the juice only. I prefer to keep the marmalade as orange peel only, so we'll proceed. Looks like this one has a little organic snacker. I don't know what's there once we slice this. If there's something inside, we'll certainly take that away and choose another one. You know, I thought you might be interested to see the inside of a Meyer lemon. I know a lot of people out of California haven't seen these because they're not in the markets. They don't ship well. They're not easy to preserve because the skin is quite thin and very pliable. Very juicy. You could eat it like an orange for those of you who have lemon in the morning with their hot water. It's an excellent choice. Whereas the Eureka, you can tell how thick the skin is and actually very firm, the lemon. So there's a little citrus news, or citrus tidbit rather. Nothing gets wasted here. Obviously not going to use the seeds in the marmalade, but the seeds are really great if you're making pectin for future, you know, jams or jellies. And then the ends of the citrus, we always save and dehydrate and use in our personal care, in our soap. Forever Florida is a very popular exfoliant and ingredient. So certainly making our own, knowing that they're organic, exactly where they came from, is something our clients are pleased with. Okay, so we'll get on to the apple pectin that we make, and it's quite, you know, it's not like a jelly. This is just used to make the jam. So we'll move forward. I just think the color of this is so beautiful. And we'll pour that into into the pot of sugar and the oranges and our little apple, green apple. It's called green apple jelly, and we have a couple trees that have beautifully tart green apples, and then of course if you leave them long enough they turn red. So they're actually not the pippin apples, like if you say green apple in a pie. They are actually a different type of apple, and we don't know what they are. We inherited those trees. They're 60-year-old trees. And no one seemed to know the name, and frankly, it doesn't matter. They give us delicious apples that we use in many ways, and this is just one of them. So we'll let this simmer, and we'll come back. Wish we had smell-o-vision for you. You know, I had an idea, possibly the soap makers who watch our channel and the people who enjoy our soap, as well as our retailers, might have interest in seeing what this is. This is actually the orange peel that comes from oranges, dehydrated, obviously, and is quite nice as feels like not quite as thin as a powdered sugar, but very light and powdery at the same time. Nice in our soap. Our Forever Florida range has an abundance of this in it, as well as a few others for the feet. And just thought you might want to see what it looked like. So orange peel it is, in many forms. I showed this to you already. This orange peel is from, excuse me, this lemon peel is from a limoncello that was, this is 2011, so this is 2009, and it's happy here. Limoncello has alcohol and sugar, so it's preserved in its own way, and it's nice for sipping. And we do use it in some of our personal care because the aroma is quite intense and wonderful. So again, nothing goes to waste here, and we enjoy doing this and sharing it with you. So stay tuned. Our oranges are simmering. Let's see. No, I don't think you can even see one little bubble. Did see a few seeds that snuck in here, but frankly, it doesn't matter to me. Even when I eat an apple, I eat the seeds, or watermelon. Because they're organic, maybe that's why I'm not so concerned about it. And in the marmalade, it just makes it a little thicker with the pectin that it offers. So I'm certainly not going to fish them out, although it wasn't really intentionally put in there. Okay, this will take a little while, and the aroma, and hope you'll stay tuned. Thank you. Simmering update. More bubbles. Woo! Steaming up the camera too. Time for a stir. What did I say? Stir? Time for a stir. Here we are, day two, or part two. Well, part two and day two of the organic orange marmalade. And smells good. It's cooled down again. And we'll come back to it again for part three. The best part, of course, is part five. That's what part this is. All parts complete. And now the best part comes. Hope you'll have a great breakfast, as will we. Thanks for watching. Anoush Botanical on Twitter and YouTube. Please join us. Thank you for watching.